The human body is an incredible self-repairing machine, but it is always susceptible to permanent damage caused by aging and disease. Everyone can benefit from the new technologies provided by regenerative medicine.
People now live longer if we use the current standard medicine to deal with the individual problem. That will be a huge cost. We need to develop a new technology.
我们的就是说，要调动一个个性化的一个再生修复的一个过程，调动这个系统来达到自身的修复，而和以前的之前提到的一种再生的修复是不一样的。Professor
Kang's research has led to a system of 3D printing to replace diseased arteries by an artery from the same individual. You can't get more personal than that.
In 2009, the Regenerative Medicine Research Center was established at West China Hospital in Chengdu. Since then, their goal has been to use stem cells not just to repair, but also to replace damaged blood vessels.
Stem cells is our personalized medicine. They have the capacity in our body to differentiate into any tissue if the tissue or our body needed. We want to develop a personalized medicine, use stem cells to set up a tissue injury signaling.
Their approach will work to mitigate the long-term effects tissue damage can have on individuals as they live with the effects of aging and disease.
If we have a long-term injury, the stem cells do not have enough capacity to fix the problem, then we will develop a non-functional repair, which is scar tissue. Inside our body, for instance, heart, how you can remove the scar tissue, that's the challenge. Regenerative medicine is really needed to make stem cells recognize where to go to make this repair.
To make this possible, Professor Kang and his team have created a novel process known as destination-engaged vector-evolving lineage organ regeneration, or DEVELOR.
这项技术其实就是一项调动机体自身的一个修复系统，也就是说，调动一个个性化、一个患者本身或者说一个病人本身的一些自我修复系统来修复他损伤的一个机制。在临床上，它就是一个来自于自己的一个修复，不存在异体的影响。所以说，对患者而言，它可以带来就是说我们在医学上一种全新的一种治疗方案。
By combining the reestablishment of tissue injury signaling with 3D bioprinting of a stem cell graft, researchers are able to replace blood vessels in the body.
We use a 3D bioprinting process. We use stem cells as a printer ink.
所谓生物墨汁，它其实是一个特殊的生物材料与细胞的混合体系。那我们通过 3D 生物打印设备 将这个生物墨汁逐层的打印，然后累加固化成型，最终就可以形成我们所想要的组织或者器官的这种结构体。我们通过培养以后，在墨汁里面包裹的这些细胞就会经历增殖、迁移、分化、相互建立连接，那最终就形成一个完整的有机体，形成一个有组织结构和功能的这样一个 组织或者器官。We simply replace
blood vessel with 3D bioprinted stem cell graft. Only about 1 week, you can see stem cells develop into different layer of vascular tissues.
我们现在使用生物墨汁已经成功的在恒河猴体内实现了血管组织的再生。那么在恒河猴机体的自主诱导下， 它就成功地分化成了血管组织的这种细胞，包括内皮细胞和平滑肌细胞。I
would expect within this year we should be able to do the clinical trial for humans for blood vessels.
那所以这套系统在血管组织可以实现，那么在机体的，比如心肌的梗死和肝脏的肝硬化，甚至骨缺损，我们都可以拿生物墨汁来去修复它。用康老师的话说，就是 想象力才是唯一限制我们使用生物墨汁的一个障碍。
Professor Kang's innovation has been a game changer. in the translation of this work into an effective treatment, initially for vascular disease, but this is the beginning of a whole new era.
The DEVELOR system and the work of Professor Kang is likely to have a huge influence on the future of regenerative medicine.
There's absolutely no question in my mind that this would be, in the near future, within a few years, translatable into human beings.
从我一个临床医生来看，从开始的不相信，到看到惊人的结果，其实我觉得为对未来我们的患者看到了希望，所以说我觉得这个世界是值得拥有它的。
With this approach, we will no longer wait for the problem to become a huge problem. We just deal with the problem at the beginning. So we will transform disease-based medicine into personalized medicine.